In this video, I'd like to describe the use of power meters for measuring load on the spindle and stepper motors of a CNC mill. This is an update of a previous video where I used a current and voltmeter to estimate power. The previous approach also measured apparent power instead of actual power. To understand the difference, we'll have to examine some definitions. Mechanical power is measured in horsepower, while electrical power is measured in watts. 1 horsepower is defined as 746 watts. To measure the power delivered by an electrical motor, we'll measure its consumption of watts. Power going out can't be greater than power going in, and we'll estimate the load on the motor as a ratio of its delivered to its rated horsepower. Unfortunately, since there are losses in the motor, belts, pulleys, bearings, and so on, the system is not 100% efficient, and not all supplied power will be delivered at the spindle. Electrical power can be divided into actual, apparent, and reactive power. Actual power is what the electrical company charges for and over time measures the work done. Actual power is measured in watts. Reactive power is power that does no work. It is power borrowed from the electric company to charge the electric motor's coils and is later returned. Apparent power is the total power delivered, including actual and reactive power. Apparent power is measured in kVA or kilovolt-amp and is used to size wires and circuit breakers. Unlike watts, basic multimeters can be used to calculate kilovolt amps by measuring and multiplying RMS voltage and current. To measure watts, a specialized meter is required. The ratio between actual and apparent power, or the ratio between useful and total power, is called the power factor. Ideally, a load would have a power factor of 1, where all delivered power is used. This is ideal because of benefits for production and distribution of electrical power. As a motor's load increases, its power factor increases. The motor becomes more efficient to a point. For a milling machine, we can use load as an estimate of reserve capacity and to guide us to take heavier or lighter cuts. While our previous meters behaved like a multimeter, where we measured current and voltage separate and multiply them together to produce apparent power, our new meter is able to measure these plus actual power in terms of watts and power factor. These meters are produced by Murata and consist of a panel interface with a selection button. On the back, there is a current transformer and screw terminals to attach to the mains. Current is measured by induction from a wire that passes through the current transformer, while voltage is measured at the screw terminals. A microprocessor inside of the power meter is taken into consideration the phase difference between the voltage and current waveforms. From this, it's able to measure watts and power factor. The top meter will measure the spindle motor, while the bottom meter will measure the stepper motors. Both meters are fused with an external half-amp fuse. There is no internal fusing. Here, the spindle motor is a DC motor, and the current is measured as it's passed to the driver. Power delivered to the stepper motors is measured as power delivered to their switch mode power supply. A small subpanel for these meters was cut from wood on the CNC mill. This graph measures watts and volt amps delivered to the spindle motors at various RPMs. It also shows the power factor as the RPMs are changed. The spindle was turning a half-inch drill bit at the time. A repeat of these measurements without any tool inserted in the spindle showed no difference. This graph might be useful for describing the power necessary to simply turn the spindle. In that case, at 2600 RPM, approximately 1/10 of a horsepower is necessary simply to turn the spindle. Over most of this graph, the power factor is between 0.5 and 0.6. However, under significant load, the power factor will increase to 0.7 or 0.8. If the power factor remained within this tight band between 0.5 and 0.6, it may be reasonable to use a current meter as an indication of load. However, using a power meter removes all doubt by removing the reactive component of apparent power. While a power meter may be a better approach for measuring power and thus load over a current meter, in practice, as we'll see, they each have their advantages. The milling machine that the power meter is attached to is a modified Precision Matthews 25MV. The spindle motor is a 1 horsepower DC motor. The maximum speed of the spindle is 2600 RPM. The advertised drilling capacity is 1 inch, but to drill 1 inch without step drilling is overly optimistic. In some CNC mills, the drilling capacity is not limited by the spindle, but instead by the thrust capacity of the axis motor. With this CNC mill, horsepower delivered to the spindle is the limiting factor. An advantage of the current meter over the power meter is faster response time. The power meter is only updated every second or so. In this case, the spindle motor was not able to deliver the necessary horsepower to drill the hole and ultimately stalled. The current meter spiked to 15 amp or 1800 volt amp of apparent power at 120 volts. The power meter spiked to approximately 1000 watts. I had hoped to use the power meter as an indication that the spindle was about to stall, but the slow response time of the power meter may not allow this. The combined power consumed by the three stepper motors is rarely above 70 watts. I found this to be surprisingly low, and if it turns out to be representative, there may have been no need to install a power meter for the stepper motors. The second drilling test uses a slower spindle speed and feed rate. While the spindle is under considerably less load, this is not an efficient drilling operation. These stringy chips, in addition to being dangerous, are representative of a feed rate that is too low. We can estimate the horsepower necessary to drill a half-inch hole in aluminum at 1000 RPM. These equations and constants can be found in the machinery's handbook. While this method has been derived from the experiences of drill operators over decades, it is important to recognize this is still an estimate. We'll first estimate torque necessary, then power necessary at the cutter, and then power necessary at the motor. The constant of 63,025 is the torque necessary to produce 1 horsepower in 1 revolution, and 1 horsepower was originally defined as the energy required to lift 33,000 pounds 1 foot in 1 minute. It was an estimate derived from experience with horses. Needless to say, the SI units for power are a lot cleaner. Inserting the constants into the equations, we arrive at 11.3 inch-pounds of torque required. This is 0.179 horsepower at the cutter, and assuming an efficiency of 85%, 0.211 horsepower at the motor. Given a horsepower of 746 watts, 157 watts are necessary to drill a half-inch hole in aluminum at 1000 RPM. On this mill, 35 watts are necessary to spin a spindle without a tool. This is the spindle's overhead. Adding 35 watts to the 157 estimated watt, we arrive at 192 watts of estimated power necessary to drill a half-inch hole in aluminum at 1000 RPM. A rough average of the measured power is 200 watts. These two values are surprisingly close, and this experiment will be repeated to verify consistency between estimated and actual horsepower requirements. To make measurements of power truly useful, they need to be captured by the control computer. And unfortunately, these meters have no means to feed back information to the computer. Because of the slow update rate of these meters, they may be more useful for steady-state operations than as early indication of spindle stall. I have a few other ideas of how these meters might be useful, and if those ideas work out, I'll make videos on those topics as well. If you have ideas for experiments and notice a mistake that I made, please make a comment below. I hope you enjoyed this video. It has taken the longest of any of the videos I've made to date. If you liked the video, please hit the like button and consider subscribing. More videos are coming. Until the next video, thank you for watching.